isn't it? So for our last session, we see the AC with inductive capacitance and the RLC, isn't it? So what is this in RLC? So we take a resistor, R resistors, resistor, inductor, and the capacitors are connected by the alternating source, right? Connected by the alternating source, the current IB flow towards the circuit, isn't it? So for previous sessions, we see about the AC with capacitance and the RLC circuit, isn't it? Here, RLC is one of the important topics in which when the current flow towards the resistance, the voltage and current are in the same phase. When it is flow towards the capacitance, the voltage lag behind the voltage. What is that? The voltage lag behind the current, and the current lead the voltage by the phase of wave into then capacitance. What is that? For the capacitance, what happened here? For the capacitance, the voltage lag behind the current. What is that? The voltage lag behind the I by the phase of I by 2. So when the current will be flowing towards the circuit, we find the impedance. What's the impedance we find the? Z is equal to root of R square plus XL minus XC the whole square. R is equal to root of R square plus XL minus XC the whole square. And XL represents the impedance. What is my impedance? Impedance means the net resistance offered by the capacitance, resistance and the inductance, isn't it? That's called as an impedance. What is the unit of impedance? Ohm. What is the unit of impedance? Ohm. Then we see the phase, isn't it? What's the phase exam? Tan phi is equal to what is that? Tan phi is equal to XL minus XC by half. Tan phi is equal to what is that? Tan phi is equal to VL minus VBC by V half. Isn't it? Then we see the three cases. Then what's the first case? We see if XL will be greater than XC, what is that? If XL will be greater than XC, means the value will be, the phase angle will be positive. So the voltage lead the current. What is that? The voltage lead the current. So the circuit is purely inductive. Then for the second case, we take as that XL will be less than XC. So the phase angle will be negative. What is that? The phase angle will be negative. Then we see the circuit is purely capacitive. Then last case we see that XL is equal to XC. So if it is XL is equal to XC, means the phase angle will be zero. So the circuit is purely resistance, isn't it? Isn't it? So this is the part we see in the previous topic, isn't it? So what is my RLC? Our RLC circuit when the resistance, inductance, capacitance, they are connected in the series by alternating source. Okay. Then when the current will be flow towards the circuit, there will be a point. What's the point? The here for resistance, the voltage and current will be same phase. For inductance, voltage lead the current by the phase of pi by 2. For capacitance, voltage lag I by the phase of pi by 2. From there we find the impedance, then we find the phase angle. From this phase side we find the three cases, isn't it? So this will be basically in the previous part. The next one is that the frequency resonance in the RLC circuit. What is that? The frequency resonance in the RLC circuit. So when the frequency of our alternating source, what is that? When the frequency of our alternating source is equal to the, okay, when the frequency of alternating source is equal to the natural frequency of a circuit. Okay, then what is the point? When the frequency of alternating source will be equal to the natural frequency of a circuit, then the current in the circuit becomes maximum. The current in the circuit reaches maximum. So that's called as an electrical resonance. That's called as an electrical resonance. So what is electrical resonance? When the frequency of alternating source is equal to the natural frequency of a circuit, so the current in the circuit is reaches maximum, that called as an electrical resonance. So the frequency, what is that? The frequency at which the resonance takes place, what is that? The frequency at which the resonance takes place, the frequency is called as the resonance frequency, okay? So first one is that electrical resonance. What is that? Electrical resonance. That is first one. What is electrical resonance? That is what is electrical resonance? When the frequency of an alternating source is equal to the frequency of natural frequency of a circuit, means the current in a circuit reaches maximum. What is that? The current in a circuit reaches maximum. So what is that? Then the circuit is said to be electrical resonance. What is that? The circuit is said to be electrical resonance. Then the frequency, what is that? The frequency at which the resonance takes place, that's called as resonance frequency. Okay? Clear? From this, resonance frequency omega r is equal to 1 by root of LC. Omega r is equal to root of 1 by root of LC. We know that omega r is equal to 2 pi f. Omega r is equal to 2 pi f. So if you substitute the expression for the delta, 2 by f is equal to 1 by root of lc. From this frequency is equal to 1 by 2 pi into root of lc. Frequency is equal to 1 by 2 pi into root of lc. Clear? Clear? So what's the point? What is my electric resistance? When the frequency of applied source is equal to the natural frequency of a circuit, then the current in the circuit will be maximum, then the circuit is said to be electrical resonance. So the frequency at which the electrical resonance takes place, what is that? The frequency at which the electrical resonance takes place, that's called as the resonance frequency. So omega is equal to 1 by root of lc. So omega is equal to 2 pi f, you know, such to the 2 pi f is equal to 1 by lc. So f is equal to 1 by 2 pi into root of lc. Okay, clear? So at resonance is, what is that? At resonance condition. What is that? At resonance condition, what's the formula is that? Omega I is equal to 1 by root of Lc. Take a square root on both sides. Omega R square is equal to 1 by Lc. Omega square means we can split into omega R and omega, isn't it? So omega R is equal to 1 by Lc. Okay? Then either should have omega L to move towards the omega is equal to what we take the omega R into L is equal to 1 by omega C. So what is my omega? Already we learned in AC inductance and AC capacitance. The resistance offered by the inductance is called as the inductive reactance, that's called as the XL is equal to XC. So when the circuit is a resonance condition, is one. When the circuit is a resonance condition, the inductive reactance is equal to the inductive capacitance. What is the inductive reactance is equal to the inductive capacitance. So both in the XL and XC are frequency dependent. So the resonance condition can be achieved by what is the resonance condition can be achieved by varying the frequency of applied voltage. Okay, clear? What is my inductive reactance? The resistance offered by the inductance is called as an inductive reactance. Already we learned the formula XL is equal to omega into L. Then the resistance offered by the capacitance, when we are learning AC with capacitance, XC is equal to 1 by omega into C. Isn't it? So omega R L is equal to XL, 1 by omega C is equal to XC. So when the circuit is a resonance condition, the inductive reactance is equal to inductive capacitance. Here, both XL and XC are frequency dependent, isn't it? Both XL and both inductive reactance and both inductive capacitance are frequency dependent. So when it is frequency dependent, means by changing the frequency of applied voltage, what is done? We can attain the resonance condition. What is done? By changing the frequency of applied voltage, we can attain the resonance condition. Okay? So what's the point here? This is the first part. When the frequency of a applied source is equal to the natural frequency of a circuit, the current in the circuit reaches maximum. Then the circuit is said to be electrical resonance. So the frequency at which the resonance takes place, the frequency is called as a, what is it? Resonant frequency. From that electrical resonance, omega is equal to 1 by root of Lc, omega is equal to 2 pi f, so 2 pi f is equal to 1 by root of Lc, from this f is equal to 1 by 2 pi into root of Lc. Okay, and the resonance condition omega is equal to 1 by root of Lc, we take that as forward, omega square is equal to 1 by Lc, we split the term, omega and omega is equal to 1 by Lc, from this, we interchange the term, so omega and L is equal to 1 by omega into C, omega and L is equal to inductive reactance, is an XL, and 1 by omega C is an inductive capacitance, are we getting capacitive reactance XC. So both XL and XC are frequency dependent. So by changing the frequency, the resonance condition can be attained by changing the frequency of the applied voltage. Okay. Then we are going to see the effect of resonance condition. What is that? Effect of resonance condition. So what is the effect is when the circuit of the series resonance occurs, what is that? When the resonance occurs, the impedance of the circuit will be minimum. Okay. The impedance of the circuit will be minimum, which will be equal to the resistance of the circuit. Okay. What is that? When the series resonance occurs, what is that? When the series resonance occurs, the impedance of the circuit is minimum. What is the impedance? The net resistance offered by the resistance, inductance, and capacitance. Because we are going to see the resonance in our series, isn't it? So, when the resonance, what is that? When the series resonance occurs in RLC circuit, the impedance will be minimum, which is equal to the resistance of the circuit. So the current is maximum, what is that? The current is equal to maximum, what is that? The current is equal to maximum. That shows the frequency curves, okay? So what's the point for resonance circuits? XL is equal to XC. So when a series resonance occurs, XL is equal to XC. What's the formula for impedance? Z is equal to root of R square plus X square minus X C the whole square. So if in the place of X R you substitute value of X C means what we get? In the place of X R if you substitute value of X C means we get 0, isn't it? So Z is equal to root of R square plus 0. Z is equal to root of R square. From this expression we can see that Z is equal to R. So when the circuit is at the resonance condition, the impedance of a circuit will be minimum, which will be almost equal to the resistance of a circuit, which will be almost equal to the resistance of a circuit. So when the impedance will be minimum, which will be equal to the resistance of a circuit, means the current in the circuit reaches maximum value. What is that? The current in the circuit reaches maximum value. From this expression, if you have to find the value of current, the maximum current Vm Im is equal to Vm by root of R square plus XL minus XC the whole square. When it is at resonance condition, what is that? When it is at resonance condition means XL minus XC, it will be 0. So what we get? Im is equal to Vm by root of R square. So Im is equal to Vm by R. So the current in the maximum current circuit, what is that? The maximum current in the circuit is limited by the resistance of a circuit. What is that? The maximum current in the value will be limited by the resistance of a circuit. So for smaller resistance, what is that? For smaller resistance, the current will be maximum. For larger resistance, the current will be minimum. So for small resistance, what is that? For small resistance, the current will be maximum. For large resistance, the current will be minimum. Okay? Clear? So what is the effect of a resonance in smaller circuit? When the resonance state is what? When a resonance in RL circuit take place, what is that? When a circuit at resonance take place means the impedance of a circuit will be minimum, it will be almost equal to the resistance of a circuit, so the current in the circuit will be maximum. So from this point, whenever the resonance will be take place in RL circuit, the current reaches the maximum values. So what happens? The current reaches the maximum values, so there will be large amount of current will be flow towards the circuit. Okay? So from this point, the current will be limited by what is that? The value of current will be limited by the resistance R. So from this graph, it shows that for small resistance, the current will be maximum. For large resistance, the current will be minimum. Okay? Clear? Clear. The next one is the application of RLC circuit. Okay? What is the application of RLC circuit? So the RLC circuit is mainly used for that. The RL circuit will mainly use for filters, oscillators, and also they mainly use for the voltage multipliers. Okay? So the RLC circuit is mainly used for the filters, oscillators, and also the voltage multipliers. The main use of RL circuit is that tuning in. What is that? The main advantage of RL circuit is that tuning in TV and radio system. Okay? TV and radio systems. We know that the signals from R, the signals from our many broadcasting station will be done. The signals from the many broadcasting station will be available in the air, isn't it? How should we have here? If you want to select, for example, to sense the signal of a particular channel means we should tune it, isn't it? We should change the channel. If you want to change it, if you want to select a proper channel means we should change the channel. So by changing means by tuning the channel, isn't it? So what's the application of RLC circuit? The RLC circuit is mainly used for the filters, oscillators, voltage multipliers. The main use of oscillator, main use of RLC circuit is tuning in radio and TV systems. Okay. So the signal from the broadcasting channels, what is that? The signals from the broadcasting channels are free in that. So if you want to select a particular channel, means we should tune the frequency of the channels, right? So here, the tuning is done by the variable capacitance. What is that? The tuning will commonly achieved by the capacitance of the varying parallel capacitors. Okay? From by changing the frequency. When the frequency will be equal to the frequency of a signal, the resonance will be take place, so the maximum current will be flow towards the circuit. The resonance will be at first, so the current will be reached the maximum amplitude. So when the current will be reached the maximum amplitude, they select the proper channel. Okay? So assume it on. Just assume, you know, they having a large number of frequency of channels there. Yeah. Because if you have a different number of channels, from these channels they broadcasting a different number of frequency signals. So if set a particular frequency means what is the? If you want to set a particular frequency means it should be done by the capacitance of a capacitance of a parallel capacitance. The tuning is done by the capacitance of a parallel capacitance. So by tuning the channel, okay, what is the frequency of a source? What is the? Here it will be our TV analysis systems. When the frequency will be matches the frequency of a broadcasting channel means what is the? When the frequency will be matches the frequency of a broadcast signal, the resonance frequency, the resonance will be take place. So when the resonance will be take place, means what happen here? The maximum current will be flow towards the circuit. Okay, clear? So what are the application of RRC? The application is mainly used for the filters, oscillators, and voltage multipliers. One of the major advantages of RRC is the tuning in tuning circuits in radio and in TV systems. It will be done by how the tuning will be achieved by? The tuning will be achieved by capacitance of a parallel capacitors. So by tuning the frequencies, when the frequency will be matches the frequency of a broadcasting channel, the resonance will be taken. So the maximum current will be reaches the maximum amplitude. So it select the proper channels. Okay, clear? Understand? So whenever the electric resonance will be taken, the current in the circuit reaches maximum. Why it is reaches maximum means the impedance of the circuit will be almost zero or almost minimum, which is equal to the resistance of the circuit. Okay, which is equal to the resistance of a circuit. The next one is the Q factor or quality factor. The next one is the Q factor or quality factor. So what is Q factor? So when a circuit will be in resonance condition, what is the? When RLC circuit is in resonance condition, what is the? When the RLC circuit is in resonance condition, what happens there? The current in circuit will be maximum. So the current will be maximum means the voltage across the inductance or capacitance also maximum. Means the voltage across the inductance or capacitance also increased. So the magnification of voltage of series resonance, what is the? The magnification of voltage in series RLC circuit is called as the Q factor. Okay. So we know when the RLC circuit is in resonance condition means, what is the? When the RLC circuit is in the resonance condition means the current will be maximum. Okay. The current will be maximum means the voltage across the inductance or capacitance also increases. So the voltage, what is the? The magnification of a voltage in series resonance or series RLC circuit is called as the Q factor. Otherwise, if this means that the Q factor is defined as, what is the? The Q factor is defined as the ratio of the voltage drop across, what is that? The voltage drop across the inductance or capacitance to, what is that? The voltage drop across the inductance or capacitance to the applied voltage. Okay, so what is Q factor? The Q factor is defined as the ratio of voltage drop across the inductance or capacitance, what is that? The voltage drop across the inductance of capacitance to the applied voltage. Inductance of capacitance to the applied voltage. So we get a, what we get a? VL by VR. So what we get a? IM into XL by IM into R. IM IM cancel. So the Q factor is equal to XL by R. Okay. Already we know the formula. XL is equal to omega R into L. XL is equal to omega R into L. So if the substitute is what we get up, the Q factor is equal to what is the? Q factor is equal to omega R into L by R. But we know the formula for omega. What's the formula for omega? Omega R is equal to 1 by root of LC. Isn't it? So if the substitute is what we get up, Q factor is equal to what is the? Q factor is equal to omega R is equal to 1 by root of LC. Isn't it? So if the substitute means 1 by root of LC into L by R. So here L will be cancelled, means what happened here? 1 by R into root of L by C. 1 by R into root of L by C. Otherwise, here you have to write one more sentence, okay? The L will be represented by root of L into root of L, isn't it? The L will be represented by root of L into L by L. So if you substitute this, what we get here? 1 by root LC into root L into root L by R. So the root of L will be cancelled. So if you rearrange the terms, what we get? 1 by r into root of l by c. The q factor is equal to what is that? The q factor is equal to 1 by r into root of l by c. So from this we can say that the number of times, what is that? The number of times the voltage across the inductance or capacitance will be depends on what is that? It's greater than the applied voltage resistance, okay? This was the number of voltage applied across the inductance or capacitance will be greater than the applied voltage. So the voltage across the inductance or capacitance will be greater than the applied voltage. So what is the Q factor? The Q factor we know that when the RLC circuit is resonance condition means the current in the circuit is maximum. So the voltage will be the voltage across the inductance or capacitance also increased. So the magnification of voltage in RLC circuit is called as Q factor. Otherwise, you can simply define as the Q factor is defined as the ratio of voltage drop across the inductance of capacitance to the applied voltage. What is that? The ratio of voltage drop across the inductance of capacitance to the applied voltage. So VL by VR is also Im into XL by Im into R. Im and cancel. You know the value of XL is equal to omega and VL. So what is that? Omega and VL by L. But you know the value of omega R is equal to 1 by root of LC. So we substitute the 1 by root of LC into L by R. We know that L is equal to root of L into root of L. So root of L into root of L. Here root L, root L will be cancelled. So Q factor is equal to 1 by R into root of L by C. So the physical meaning of Q factor is, what is that? What's the meaning of Q factor means? The number of times, what is that? The number of times the voltage applied across the inductance or capacitance are greater than the applied voltage. Greater than the applied voltage. Okay, clear? So the next one is that power in an AC circuit. Okay. So the power is, what is my power? The rate of electrical consumption. What is that? The power in an AC circuit is defined as the rate of consumption of electrical energy in a circuit. So what is my power in an AC circuit? The power in an AC circuit is defined as, what is that? The power in an AC circuit is defined as the rate of electrical consumption. What is that? The rate of consumption of electrical energy in a circuit. What is that? What is my power? The rate of consumption of electrical energy in a circuit is called as the power in an AC circuit. Always you simply better say that the power in an AC circuit is defined as the product of an instantaneous current and voltage of a circuit. The product of instantaneous current and voltage of a circuit. We know in AC circuit, both the current and voltage of the changes are with respect to the time, isn't it? So the power also will calculate the instant of time. Because DC circuit, the power and voltage will be same. For AC circuit, the power and voltage will be same. Different means we can calculate the power at the instant of circuit. Okay? So what is the power in an AC circuit? The power in an AC circuit is defined as the rate of consumption of electrical energy in a circuit. Otherwise, the power in an AC circuit is defined as the product of current into voltage of an AC circuit. Current into voltage of an AC circuit. So the instantaneous current, instantaneous voltage V is equal to Vm into sin omega g. V is equal to Vm into sin omega g. And the current I is equal to Im into sin omega g plus pi. Omega g plus pi. Here the pi represents the phase angle. What is that? The pi represents the phase angle. Pi represents the phase angle. So if you substitute the expression is what you get up, power P is equal to Vm sin omega g into Im sin omega t plus pi. Okay, sin omega t plus pi. So from this expression you can define the elaborate expression by using the formula sin a plus b is equal to sin a cos b plus cos a sin b, isn't it? So we are going to expand that term. So we just here is the power is equal to Vm Im into, okay, sin omega g. Then we are going to elaborate that term. Sin omega g cos phi, then cos omega t sin phi, right? Sin omega t cos phi plus cos omega t sin phi. Okay. Then you are going to multiply the sin omega t instead. Okay. We are going to multiply the sin omega t instead. This what we get. The power p is equal to Vm Im into this. The power p is equal to Vm Im into sin square omega t cos phi. Sin square omega t cos phi plus sin omega t cos omega t sin phi. Okay, so this much water point is done. What is my power in AC circuit? The power in AC circuit is defined as what is done? The power in AC circuit is defined as the rate of consumption of electricity in the circuit, or it is defined as the product of instantaneous voltage and current in AC circuit. So the instantaneous voltage V is equal to Vm into sin omega t, the instantaneous current I is equal to Im into sin omega t plus phi. Phi represents the phase angle between the voltage and current. What is phi? The phi represents the phase angle between the voltage and current. Okay. So if you substitute the values, then you expand the form of a sin omega t plus phi, sin a plus b. So we expand that, then multiply with the sin omega t. So sin square omega t cos phi plus sin omega t cos omega t sin phi. From this, the average value of sin square omega t over the cycle is 1 by 2. The average value of sin square omega t is equal to 1 by 2. Then sin omega t cos omega t sin phi is equal to 0. Sin omega t cos omega t sin phi is equal to 0. So if you substitute this above expression into what we get, the power p is equal to Vm Im into 1 by 2 into cos phi plus 0. Okay, 1 by 2 cos phi plus 0. So if you write the term means the power p is equal to what is one? The power p is equal to Vm Im into 1 by 2 into cos phi. Okay. The expression, the 2 can be represented by root of 2 into root of 2. The 2 can be represented by root of 2 into root of 2. So if you substitute what you get, P is equal to Vm by root 2 into Im by root 2 into cos phi. Okay. Here the Vm by root 2 is equal to V RMS, then Im by root 2 is equal to I RMS. So if you substitute the second expression is what we get, the power P is equal to V RMS I RMS into cos phi. Here the V RMS I RMS, what is not? The expression for V RMS I RMS represents the apparent power, and the cos phi represents the power factor. Okay, the VRMS IRMS represents the apparent power, and cos phi represents the power factor. So the average power of an AC circuit, what is done? The average power of an AC circuit is called as the true power of an AC circuit. What is done? The average power of an AC circuit is called as the true power of an AC circuit. Okay, clear? So what is the power of an AC circuit? The power of an AC circuit is defined as product of a instantaneous voltage and current, or the rate of consumption of electrical energy in the circuit. Then we have power is equal to I into V. We substitute the form of instantaneous voltage and current. Then expanding the form of sin omega t in sin a plus V. Expand the term, multiply by sin omega t. Then we say that the expression for the sin, average value of sin square omega t is equal to 1 by 2. Then sin omega t cos omega t is equal to 0. Then we have substitute that. So V Im Im is equal to 1 by 2 into cos phi plus 0. The tan of 2 can be expressed by root 2 into root 2. So 1 by root 2 into 1 by root 2. So Vm by root 2, Im by root 2 into cos phi. Vm by root 2 is equal to VRMS, Im by root 2 is equal to IRMS. So we substitute this what we get, the power is equal to IRMS into cos phi. Here VRMS, IRMS represents the apparent power, and cos phi represents the power factor. So the average value of an AC, what is that? The average value of an AC is called as the power in a circuit. Okay, clear? Then when if the circuit is purely resistive means, what is that? If the circuit is purely resistive means, if the circuit will be purely resistive. So we have four cases. Case 1, if the circuit is purely resistive means, the phase angle between the voltage and current is equal to, what is that? The phase angle between the voltage and current is equal to 0. So cos phi cos 0 is equal to 1. So the average power effect is V RMS into I RMS. So what's the first case? When the circuit is purely resistive, means the phase angle between the voltage and current is equal to 0. So cos 0 is equal to 1. So the power is equal to V RMS I RMS. Then for the second case, for case 2, when a circuit is purely inductive or capacitive, means the phase angle between the voltage and current is equal to plus or minus pi by 2. So the cos pi by 2 is equal to 0. So the average power in a circuit is, or the power in a circuit will be 0. So what's the first case? When the circuit is purely resistive, the phase angle between the voltage and current is equal to 0. So cos 0 is equal to 1. So power is equal to V RMS into I RMS. For case 2, when the circuit is purely capacitive or inductive, the phase angle will be plus or minus pi by 2. Cos pi by 2 is equal to 0. So the power consumed by the circuit is equal to 0. Then for RLC circuit, what is that? If it is RLC circuit, means the phase angle phi is equal to tan inverse of x1 minus xc by r. The phase angle phi is equal to tan inverse of x1 minus xc by c, xc by r, and the power is equal to V RMS into I RMS into cos phi. Okay. So for a circuit, when the circuit is a resonance condition, means what is that? When the circuit is a resonance condition, means the phase angle phi is equal to 0. What is that? When the circuit is a resonance condition, means the phase angle phi is equal to 0. So cos 0 is equal to 1. Okay. Cos 0 is equal to 1 means the power is equal to V RMS into I RMS. So what are the four cases in the power in AC circuit? For the first case, when the phase angle will be 0 means R, and the second is purely resistive, means the phase angle between the voltage and current is equal to 0. So cos 0 is equal to 1. So the power is equal to V RMS into I RMS. For case 2, when the circuit is purely capacitive or inductive, means the phase angle between the voltage and current is plus or minus pi by 2, so cos pi by 2 is equal to 0, so the average power consumed by the circuit also 0. For case number 3, for the RLC circuit, the phase angle phi is equal to tan inverse of x1 minus xc by r, and the power will be V RMS I RMS into cos phi. Okay, in which the phase angle will be, what is that? When the phase angle will be 0, means when the circuit is a resonance condition, means the phase angle will be 0, so cos 0 is equal to 1, the power is equal to V RMS into I RMS. Okay, clear? So for today's session, whatever part we learned that, first we see what is the electrical resonance or resonant frequency, then we see the effect of electrical resonance, then we see the application of electrical resonance, then we see the Q factor, define Q factor is one of the important two models, then we see the power in the AC circuit. Okay, we see the power in the AC circuit. Clear?